Weeksy, let's take a deeper dive into the Jonathan Gibson thing because he mentioned that he's been their MVP. We all know it. How can you not be when this team is giving up nearly 39 shots per game? Is that sustainable for a team to have success?
It's not really sustainable for a team to have success, but one thing that is for certain, Jonathan Gibson is exactly who we thought he was going back to his days with the Kitchener Rangers. This Pittsburgh native is downright dominant. And when you look at the numbers and you do a deep dive for what he's brought to the table, same too for Ryan Miller, who's had a great career. But you look at the, take a look at these 5-on-5 danger shots faced. 91 for Gibson, 91 at this point. That's a lot for only 10 games played. So he's averaging 9.1 of those per game. And you look at the gap between him and Cam Ward, who's at number two. Take a look at the danger save percentage leaders here. Look at where John Gibson is, way out ahead of the pack. Varlamov, who I saw up close at the Garden, has been great. Ben Bishop has played really well. Dubé in Minnesota, Devan Dubnyk, has been excellent. Carey Price, you want to know how well he's played? He just eclipsed Patrick Roy for second all-time in wins for the Montreal Canadiens. And then there's John Gibson, who is the bell mark, so to speak, and the benchmark. So that's indicative of how great he's been, how consistent he's been, and how he's been able to over-deliver for this team. I got to tell you something. There's one area of this team that's delivering right now. It's the goaltending. It's John Gibson, Ryan Miller, and their goalie coach, Sudsy Maharaj, have done an outstanding job because they're facing a lot of shots, high volume and high quality. And this Anaheim Ducks team, as you just heard, only years ago, this is a team that won the Jennings.
Right.
This is a team that won the Jennings.
What happened?
Take a look at this board in terms of the yield right now. I mean, they're on a historic pace.
Historic.
This is a historic pace. So it's something where they're going to really need to clean this up in their game. And, you know, you've got to respect the competition. The other guys get paid on the first and 15th, too. You're in the Western Conference. It's a heck of a lot of good players. You're in the Pacific. That's a lot of Johnny Hockey, a lot of McDavid, among other players that they have to go up against that are getting the lion's share of these A-plus opportunities on Gibson. So Randy Carlyle is going to have to figure this out at some point. Him and the coaching staff have to devise a plan where they make some defensive adjustments and alleviate some of the pressure on John Gibson and the goalies.
Because we can sit here and say, wow, John Gibson's been amazing, and he has.
Totally has.
And there's all the credit in the world to him.
Yes.
But at the same time, I mean, what's it like for a goalie to have to go in night after night and know that you're probably going to face that body of work?
Well, I've had that at different points. Yeah, exactly. I've had that at different points in my career. I mean, the hard part of the position, so to speak, is that you can't really say what you're thinking. You can't say what you're feeling. You literally just have to bite your tongue, go out there, kick, give your teammates a chance to win, and try to be as great as you can be. The good thing for them is he's a great goalie.
Yeah.
So they're already, and the good thing for them is when he's not in, Ryan Miller's been a great goalie and had an amazing career as well. So you take a look at that and you know that you've got that covered, but the challenges as well, some of the injuries, Manson going down, we can go up and down different guys in the lineup. But at this point in time, Ryan Getzlaff, who's their captain now, originally he said, well, this is what our goalies are supposed to do. And after Getzy got back in the lineup and he got to see it firsthand, he said, hold on a second. Wait, what? I got to retract that. We're not as good as we need to be defensively. And I think this Ducks team has a lot of nice pieces. Make no mistake about it. This team should be a contender. I have all three California teams being contenders, really. But them and the Kings have underperformed, and I'm really concerned about both teams, the Kings more so. But from the Ducks' standpoint, they need to make some defensive adjustments. Absolutely do.
Why the Kings more so than the Ducks?
Well, they don't. Jonathan Quick's injured. That's the first thing. So you get that ace. Then the second point is the Kings can't score, and they're not really defending well in front of their goalies. They haven't helped, and they're struggling to score goals. I'd say that the Anaheim Ducks, offensively, they have some more weapons, and they're scoring a little bit more consistently, if you will, than the LA Kings. What's challenged the Kings over the years has been their goal scoring. Mm. And the good news for them, though, is Ilya Kovalchuk got on track last game. So let's hope, if you're a Kings fan, that Ilya's starting to feel a little bit more comfortable. And I know he's trying to be unselfish and to be a team-first player, but maybe he a little bit more selfish with the puck, take some more of those shots we're accustomed to seeing him take, being a point-of-game player throughout the course of his career. Dustin Brown is back in the lineup. I think that helps their net front game, and that probably helps Anze Kopitar as well. But all things being equal right now, I'm more worried about the Kings because the goal scoring has been a deficiency of theirs and a challenging point in their makeup, and it continues to be that.
Yeah.
And now in the absence of Jonathan Quick, they're going to have to buckle down defensively and get a little bit more industrial on the offensive end, get to the front of the opposing net, which should be helped by Dustin Brown's return.
It's been a strange start to the season, huh? To see the Pacific just really jumbled all up.
Totally. You know what it is, Jame? You know what everybody says all the time? That's why they play the game.
That's why they play the
game. This is why they play the game. Because we could go over all this.
Yeah.
The coaches go over the whiteboard. Hey, guys, iPad, video, this, that, and the other. Until you get out there and play, any girls, any men, boys, girls, whatever, that play this game, you know that you throw that all out the window once you get out there and you got to perform.